In early 2020, the world came to a standstill.
Coronavirus.
The coronavirus.
Virus has a new official name, COVID-19.
The COVID-19.
There are two cases now in England.
More than 50 new cases overnight.
So at least 565 people are dead.
Characterized as a pandemic.
Empty streets, shuttered shops, overwhelmed hospitals, and people wearing masks became the global reality almost overnight. The COVID-19 pandemic struck with a speed and intensity that few could imagine. Scientists around the world faced an unprecedented challenge: how to stop a virus that was spreading faster than any vaccine had ever been developed before. Within a year, a new class of vaccines, based on messenger RNA or mRNA, would be authorized for emergency use, protecting millions and changing the course of the pandemic. How was this possible? To understand, we must travel back nearly 50 years to the birth of a technology that would seem impossible to many at the time. The story begins in the 1960s, when scientists first discovered messenger RNA, a molecule that carries genetic instructions from DNA to the cell's protein-making machinery. This discovery sparked a revolutionary idea. If cells could be instructed to produce specific proteins, could we use this mechanism to fight diseases or even develop vaccines? The concept was elegant, but the reality was far from simple. Early experiments with mRNA revealed a series of obstacles. The molecule was extremely fragile, degrading quickly once introduced into the body, and it triggered a strong immune response as the body recognized it as foreign. These technical hurdles led to decades of skepticism. While the potential of mRNA was evident in theory, practical applications seemed out of reach. Early trials faltered and funding dwindled. Many scientists moved on to other areas of research, leaving mRNA in what some called scientific purgatory. Yet, amid these challenges, a few determined researchers continued to pursue the promise of mRNA, believing that one day, their persistence would pay off. One of the most notable figures in this story is Katalin Karikó, a Hungarian-born scientist who emigrated to the United States in the mid-1980s. She became obsessed with the idea that mRNA could be harnessed for medical use. Karikó faced constant resistance. Colleagues dismissed her ideas as unrealistic. Grant applications were repeatedly rejected, and the broader scientific community considered mRNA a lost cause. But she persisted, working quietly in university laboratories, convinced that the solution lay in understanding and overcoming the body's immune response to mRNA. In the early 2000s, Karikó met Drew Weissman, an immunologist at the University of Pennsylvania. Together, they made a breakthrough that would prove pivotal. By substituting a single chemical building block in the mRNA molecule with a modified version called fludarabine, they dramatically reduced the molecule's tendency to provoke an immune response. This small modification solved one of the key problems that had plagued mRNA research for decades: how to make it stable and safe for use in humans. What once seemed impossible suddenly became feasible. By the 2010s, the mRNA technology began to attract attention from biotech startups willing to take risks. Moderna in the United States and BioNTech in Germany emerged as pioneers, betting on mRNA despite widespread skepticism. Investors were wary. The technology had failed in numerous trials before, and the path to a viable product remained uncertain. Nonetheless, both companies pushed forward, conducting early clinical trials targeting cancer and rare genetic diseases. These trials laid the groundwork for what would soon become a historic global effort. By January 2020, the COVID-19 pandemic was no longer just a distant threat, it had become a global emergency. Hospitals in Wuhan were overflowing, cases began appearing across Europe and the United States, and governments scrambled to contain the virus. Scientists raced against time. Within days of the viral genome being published, researchers at Moderna in Cambridge, Massachusetts, and BioNTech in Mainz, Germany, had designed mRNA sequences that could potentially prime the human immune system to fight SARS-CoV-2. Unlike traditional vaccines, which often require growing the virus in cell cultures, a process that can take months or even years, mRNA vaccines work differently. They instruct cells to produce a harmless piece of the virus, usually the spike protein, which trains the immune system to recognize and fight the real virus if exposed. This approach had never been used on such a scale, but it offered an unprecedented advantage: speed. Once the genetic sequence of SARS-CoV-2 was known, vaccine candidates could be designed and produced within days. In March 2020, Moderna launched its Phase 1 clinical trial, enrolling a small group of volunteers to test safety and dosage. Simultaneously, BioNTech, Indiana collaboration with Pfizer, began its own trials in Germany and later expanded them to the United States. Normally, vaccine development follows a rigid sequence: preclinical tests, Phase 1, Phase 2, Phase 3 clinical trials, and regulatory approval, a process that typically spans 10 to 15 years. For COVID-19, this timeline was compressed to less than a year. The world watched anxiously. Skepticism was widespread. Critics worried that the vaccines had been rushed, that mRNA technology was untested at scale, and that potential long-term effects were unknown. Social media fueled fears and conspiracy theories, questioning the safety of a vaccine developed in record time. Yet, scientists reassured the public, mRNA vaccines, while new in widespread application, had undergone decades of research, and the clinical trials were rigorous and transparent. By July 2020, preliminary data from Moderna's Phase 1 trial showed that volunteers developed strong antibody responses, and side effects were generally mild, fatigue, headache, and temporary soreness at the injection site. BioNTech reported similar findings. Encouraged, both companies moved to Phase 2 and 3 trials, involving tens of thousands of participants across multiple countries. These trials tested not only safety, but efficacy. Could the vaccines actually prevent COVID-19 infection and severe disease? The results were staggering. By November 2020, BioNTech Pfizer announced that their vaccine demonstrated 95% efficacy in preventing COVID-19 with no serious safety concerns. Moderna followed closely, reporting 94% efficacy. For context, most flu vaccines have an efficacy rate of 40 to 60%. The speed, combined with such high effectiveness, was unprecedented in the history of vaccinology. Regulatory agencies, including the FDA and EMA, conducted accelerated but thorough reviews and granted emergency use authorizations by December 2020. Mass vaccination campaigns began almost immediately. Airports, stadiums, and community centers transformed into vaccination sites. Millions of healthcare workers, elderly individuals, and high-risk populations received the vaccine in the first weeks. By early 2021, vaccine rollouts were expanding globally, and the early data was clear: hospitalizations were dropping, and the death rate among vaccinated populations was significantly reduced. mRNA had finally fulfilled the promise that scientists like Karikó and Weissman had envisioned decades earlier. What was once considered a fragile, unstable molecule, incapable of practical use, had become the foundation of a medical breakthrough. The pandemic accelerated the adoption of mRNA technology, proving that a molecule once relegated to scientific curiosity could save lives on a massive scale. The approval of the first mRNA vaccines marked the culmination of decades of research. This was not the end of the story. It was only the beginning. The true potential of mRNA was only starting to unfold. With the success of COVID-19 vaccines, attention quickly turned to what mRNA could achieve beyond the pandemic. Researchers around the world saw a new platform for tackling some of the most challenging medical problems. Influenza, HIV, and even the Zika virus became targets for mRNA-based vaccines, with multiple clinical trials already underway. For example, Moderna launched an mRNA flu vaccine trial in 2021 that targets multiple viral strains, aiming to improve effectiveness compared to traditional seasonal vaccines. BioNTech is also developing HIV vaccines using mRNA, focusing on generating broadly neutralizing antibodies, which could protect against diverse virus variants. One of the most promising areas is personalized cancer vaccines. Traditional cancer treatments, like chemotherapy, attack both healthy and cancerous cells. mRNA allows for a more precise approach. Clinical trials in melanoma and other cancers have shown that vaccines can be customized to produce immune responses against specific tumor mutations in individual patients. Early phase studies report promising immune activation, with some patients experiencing reduced tumor progression. While still experimental, this approach represents a shift from generalized to highly targeted cancer therapy. Rare genetic disorders are also entering the spotlight. mRNA can instruct cells to produce missing or defective proteins, potentially correcting diseases at their source. For instance, preclinical studies are underway for metabolic disorders such as phenylketonuria and enzyme deficiencies. In animal models, researchers observed restoration of protein function and partial correction of disease symptoms, offering hope for patients with conditions that previously had no treatment. The speed and adaptability of mRNA remain key advantages. Once the genetic sequence of a virus or mutation is known, vaccines or therapies can be designed within weeks. Manufacturing processes are standardized, which allows rapid scaling to meet demand. Unlike traditional methods, which may require months of virus cultivation or protein purification, mRNA platforms rely on synthetic production, minimizing delays. The success of mRNA has also drawn attention to collaboration as a critical factor. Katalin, Karikó, and Drew Weissman, whose decades of dedication had been overlooked, finally received global recognition. In 2023, they were awarded the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine, not only honoring their individual contributions, but also highlighting the decades-long process of trial, error, and innovation that made these vaccines possible. Their journey demonstrates how persistence, interdisciplinary work, and scientific curiosity can eventually overcome skepticism and technical barriers. Beyond individual achievements, The COVID-19 experience reshaped global vaccine infrastructure. Countries invested in cold chain logistics, training programs, and production capacity that can now support mRNA vaccine development for other diseases. Regulatory agencies have established frameworks for faster evaluation of mRNA products without compromising safety. These developments mean that future responses to emerging pathogens or urgent medical needs can be accelerated, applying lessons learned from COVID-19 to a wider range of health challenges.